Do you ever look at a video that you shot and feel that something looks off or it just feels awkward to watch, but you don't know why? It could be such a simple fix. Here are three quick tips on video composition and how you can apply it to your iPhone and your home movie clips of your family. Not sure what I'm talking about? That's okay. It's super simple and quick to learn, I promise. Quick note, I'm not gonna break down all the whys behind these rules. I'm sure you're a parent like me with limited time, so I'm just gonna tell you exactly what to do and how to accomplish it. The first rule of composition isn't really actually a rule of composition, but it's a base, and a good base to good video is to film horizontally. Yes, filming this way for social media, Insta stories, etc., is great, but for family movie making, you definitely wanna keep your phone horizontally. You can capture so much more, especially at your kid's eye level, and you won't have to move the camera around as much. The image moves in front of the camera instead of you following the image. It's just much more comfortable for the viewer to watch.
So do you see how much movement there is from the moving the phone back and forth to be able to capture the kids dancing? If you were filming horizontally, you wouldn't have to move at all, and both kids would be in the shot.
This rule itself will be a game changer, I promise. Rule of thirds. This is where we talked about using the grid on your iPhone screen. This can help guide you till you're comfortable using the rule of thirds. If you're unsure about how to turn on the settings, I'll link the video below about how to turn on the grid settings on your camera. Having the grid helps position your subjects on the screen on where they are best placed. You want your subjects on one of the lines or at one of the intersections of the lines. This just feels more natural for the viewer. I'm gonna show you two examples of using the rule of thirds and not using the rule of thirds.
Not using the rule of thirds. There's nothing at the intersecting lines or on the third lines. But here, you see how the child is completely in line with the one third?
You can see how the rule of thirds just feels more natural and comfortable to view. The same goes for horizon images. If you're shooting a beautiful sunset over the beach or of the mountains, you want the horizon line not right in the middle of the screen. You want it on one of the third lines. Using the grid will help up your game in higher quality video settings. Headroom. This rule is probably a favorite rule because it's once you start using it, you will really appreciate the higher quality images you get. By headroom, what I mean is not having the image cut your head off. You always want a little bit of room on top, and you don't want the head too close to the bottom or too close to one of the sides. You can see how awkward this looks right here on the image of me. See, I have no headroom now, and it just feels uncomfortable to watch, right? But this looks so much more natural and comfortable to view. This rule could be specialty appointment in an interview style setting. So if you're doing a family historical video of your parents, or if you are doing kids yearly films where you, an interview style one-on-one, this would definitely be a great rule to follow. I have some samples here just kind of show you what would be some good guidelines.
There's plenty of headroom to see his eyes line up with the third line. But when I zoom in, his eyes are no longer on that third line, which took away from his headroom.
You just want to make sure to give plenty of headspace. Creating depth. I'm throwing this one in here for fun because this one is more if you want to play with the settings more of your camera. On the iPhone 10, you can tap the screen and you can focus on a particular object. So say you are filming outside at a park and there is a tree and your kids are in the background. So the tree is in a little bit of the image. If you tap that tree would become in focus and your kids would be blurry. And reverse, if you tap the kids would be in focus and the tree would be blurry. That right there is depth of field. So you can go ahead and try putting something in the foreground and focusing on them in the background or vice versa. It's a great way to create a creative aspect to your home movies. Stay tuned for how to use lighting in your home movies. I hope you like these tips. If you did, give me a thumbs up or a like or a comment to let me know what else you'd like to learn.